So here we are. We're back. We're back in an old path to a new day. We've talked about living in the kingdom that Jesus taught us to live in. We've talked about living in the way that Jesus showed us to live. And today we're going to talk about living in the same victory as Jesus. Living in victory. And so let's start with that, the question. I mean, do you feel like you're living in victory? That's a hard question to answer, isn't it? Because in some ways, we're too hard on ourselves. Some ways, we look at ourselves and we don't give ourselves credit for our progress. We don't count the little steps that have moved us so much further than we used to be. But then sometimes we're just too easy on ourselves. We look at our lives and we kind of with pride look at ourselves and go, well, I'm doing as well as anyone else. And a measuring stick of another person, we know in our heart that is not a good idea, that we should compare ourselves first to Jesus and then second to where we've been in the past and how much we've grown since then. So today we're talking about living in that victory, overcoming the things in our life that are knocking us down, like addictions, failures, waistlines, relationships, unforgiveness, all those kinds of things. Those, the things that are in our lives that when we think about them, we lose sleep over them, that when we dwell on them, the enemy brings accusation against us. We begin to think of ourselves as losers, as weak, as failure. So today we want to live in victory over those things. How did Jesus do it? And how can we experience the victory that Christ won for us? Because Romans tells us this, no, despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. So let's learn about living in the victory that Jesus had. Let's take that old path of repentance, let go of the shame, let go of the guilt, let go of the failure, let go of every accusation, and learn to live in Jesus' victory. So if we're going to do that, let's look at Jesus and let's notice three things about him. First, let's notice that Jesus Christ was victorious over expectations. Jesus did not live under the bondage or the change of the expectations of others. But I warn you, unless your righteousness is better than the righteousness of the teachers of religious law and the Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Here Jesus, in the Sermon on the Mount, tells his listeners that they have to be better. They have to exceed the Pharisees. Well, that is a tall order. The Pharisees fasted twice a week. They prayed publicly. They gave publicly. When you saw a Pharisee, you knew he was a Pharisee just by the way he dressed. And so here's Jesus saying, hey, unless your righteousness is better than that, you're not going to experience or live in the kingdom of God. But the issue was that the Pharisees lived publicly on purpose. They wanted the accolades. They wanted people to see them. They lived for the expectations of others, particularly their peers. Now, Jesus refused to agree with that. Jesus refused to live up to their expectations because Jesus lived for someone else's expectations. I don't speak of my own authority. The Father who sent me has commanded me what to say and how to say it. You see, Jesus lived for an audience of one. He didn't care if the Pharisees liked him, if the common people liked him, if the Roman rulers liked him. He didn't care about any of that stuff. His question was, is God pleased with this? Is this God's will for today? Not only did Jesus want to know what God wanted to say, but how God wanted Jesus to say it. So Jesus lived his life for one person, and that was God the Father. And that will help us get free of the expectations of others. As we learn to live for an audience of one, when we live for an audience of one, as Jesus did, we will find ourselves free from the expectations of others. So yeah, Jesus was victorious over the expectations of others, but he was also victorious over sin. Check out this verse in Hebrews. It's amazing. So then, since we have a great high priest who has entered heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold firmly to what we believe. This high priest of ours understands our weaknesses, for he faced all the same testings we do, yet he did not sin. So let us come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. There we will receive his mercy, and we will find grace to help us when we need it most. Jesus overcame sin. That should go without saying, but maybe you've never heard that before. And maybe you don't know why that's such a big deal. Well, here's why it's such a big deal. Because we have a problem with sin and with sins. big sin is a problem in the world, and it's a problem for all of us. But my most immediate challenge are the sins that are in my life from day to day, the little neglects, the unkindness that I often express. And so, yeah, sin is a problem. But it wasn't a problem for Jesus. Jesus, because he didn't need to please anybody except God, it led him into a life that he could live without sins, plural. He didn't have to commit sins to please people or to satisfy anyone, because he lived for that audience of one. And so we need to take a lesson from Jesus. I once thought these things were valuable, but now I consider them worthless because of what Christ has done. Yes, everything else is worthless when compared with the infinite value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. For his sake, I have discarded everything else, counting it all as garbage, so that I could gain Christ and become one with him. If we're going to live in victory over sin and sins in our life, we have to rely upon the righteousness of Jesus. We have to really get to know Jesus. That's where our freedom lies. That is the most valuable thing in your life. It's the most valuable thing in my life. It's not how much money we make or how much fame we have or how many likes we get on a certain picture we may post. It's not how well we do with our children. It's about whether or not we know Christ and know him well and know him deeply. That's what brings true righteousness into our lives. When we live for an audience of one, God the Father, and we know that we are empowered by a relationship with Jesus Christ. And I know that may be a little bit difficult to wrap your heart around. But God wants us on this earth not to live in defeat, especially to our sins, but to live in victory over those sins. And so he gave us Jesus Christ as an example, as a sacrifice, but also as a resurrected life that he puts within us to empower us to live rightly and righteously. So yes, Jesus, he lived in a way that he was victorious over expectations and he was victorious over sin. But the most exciting thing, the one that gives us the most hope, is that Jesus lived in victory over death. For the sin of this one man, Adam, caused death to rule over many. But even greater is God's wonderful grace and his gift of righteousness. For all who receive it will live in triumph over sin and death through this one man, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Life, every second of it, from conception to death on a cross, to resurrection again, to ascension, even through the ascension, the return that he starts living inside of his believers, it's a constant affront, attack upon death. I mean, when Jesus is born, Herod tries to kill him, and many babies are murdered because of Jesus' birth. But you look at Jesus' life, he brought life into every situation he entered. He would go into situations where there was discouragement and fear, and he would give the life of hope and of peace with God. He'd go to funerals, and in the funeral, in the person who died being resurrected. And even his own story, Jesus Christ dying on a cross and then resurrected from the dead. Jesus brought life, and that's what we're here to do, my friends. We are here to bring life into our world, into our situations. Anyone who believes in me may come and drink, for the scriptures declare, rivers of living water will flow from his heart. To live in victory over death, in victory over the fear of death, we must rely upon Christ's life within us. We must not just rely upon it, but use it and enforce it, so to speak, in the world in which we live and bring life into every situation that we can. So you see, God's people, we're supposed to live in victory, not defeat. Yes, there are defeats in our life. There are failures. What the difference is between us and those who fail is that we don't quit. We realize that the life of Christ in us will overwhelmingly conquer. We are more than conquerors because of Christ. So today, I want to challenge you and challenge myself. Live in victory. Live in joy. Give life. Live in victory over the expectations of others. Live in victory over the sins that knock you down. But live in victory over the very idea of death. Discouragement, fear, and death, they have no place. They can't stand against the Christ that's within us.